Hi guys and welcome to TechBased. In this video I'm going to show you how to enable the new details pane in the File Explorer. As we've talked about a few videos ago, I told you that Microsoft is working on refreshing the File Explorer and improving the visual design of File Explorer. And well, in the last build from the dev channel, which is the build 25276, we can encounter some of those new features such as the new details pane and some more improvements to the gallery feature from the File Explorer. Well, this feature is still under development. It's still in the early stage, so if you enable it on your main computer or even on a normal virtual machine, you may see that the File Explorer will just crash when you open it up. I'm saying this at first just so you know, but you can still try it out on your main computer or on a VM. But if you see that the File Explorer is crashing when you enable the feature, just make sure to disable it. I'm also gonna show you how to disable it, but if you want to be sure that you get to test it out, you can test it out in Windows Sandbox. Windows Sandbox is a feature from Windows 11 that basically simulates the same environment that you have on your computer. Of course, to use Windows Sandbox, you're going to need to have a machine with the latest dev channel build, and in that machine, you're going to need to enable Windows Sandbox. But before showing you how to enable the new details pane, make sure to leave a like below and also subscribe to the TechBased channel with the notification bell activated so that you won't miss any future uploads like this one. So let's begin with the video. To enable Windows Sandbox on a machine, for example, here I'm on my laptop, just go and type in the search box, turn Windows features on or off, open that app, and make sure to have Hyper-V and also Windows Sandbox enabled. Click on OK, the computer will have to restart, and then on you'll be able to open up Windows Sandbox. Of course, first of all, you're going to have to download Vive Tool on your Windows Sandbox machine. Just go ahead and download it from the link in the article below in the video's description, and make sure to download the latest version.zip on the Windows Sandbox machine. And after you download it on the Sandbox, make sure to double click on it. You can open it up with File Explorer. Click on Extract All and just extract it into this PC, local disk C, users, and then this WDAG utility account. Just select it and then click on select folder and then on extract. I'm going to have to replace the files. You're going to be asking, well, why are we extracting that there? Because if we now open up the CMD to run the necessary commands as admin, of course, that's not necessarily needed. You're going to see that this location will be opened up. It's easier. You don't need to change the location after all. Now in the CMD for the new details pane, you're going to have to run this command, which is this one. I'm just going to run it here. And then if you want to also enable the new gallery section with the new changes from this build that are hidden, you can enable also both of these two commands. A huge shout out to Phantomotion 3 for discovering these IDs. And also a note from Phantomotion 3 is that this ID 42295138 is to enable the new gallery section and not the new details pane File Explorer. So as I've said, you can just go ahead and run both of these commands as well. And you're also going to have the new gallery section. Now you're going to have to restart Windows Sandbox. Just go ahead and restart it normally, but be aware that can encounter a weird bug where after the restart, the internet will stop working on the sandbox. It happened to me, I don't know why, but make sure you have all the necessary files and things downloaded on your machine, because once you shut down the Windows Sandbox, everything will be erased. So now let me show you how the new details pane look. I'm gonna use the full screen for the File Explorer, then I'm gonna go to View, Show, and then Details Pane. And this is how the new details pane looks. I'm gonna expand this a bit so you can see it better. If we select anything, we have this new details pane, rounded corner buttons that goes hand in hand with the Windows 11 experience, activity, as you can see here, where you can click on view more, related files, related conversations, details, properties, button that doesn't currently work. And of course, you have info related to other files as well. So for example, pictures, yeah? As you can see, the activity section has now some default activities because of course Microsoft is still working on it. Related files, of course, for example purposes, I'm sure, and then details with the non-working properties button. And of course, some new buttons, share and manage access, which are backing up the assumptions that Microsoft is also gonna improve the sharing part of the File Explorer, which is really nice. And basically, this is the new details pane that you can test out. Of course, right now it's not really useful. It only has some default info, but as for the looks, it looks very, very nice. Also, this is the new gallery section that I've talked about. You can enable it using those two commands that I've told you. But for the details pane, for this new details pane, you only need to enable one command on Windows Sandbox or on your main computer or virtual machine. If you're testing this out on a virtual machine or on your main computer, you can extract Vive Tool normally on System32 and then go on from there. It's really, really simple. I'm hoping this video was useful. Thanks again to Phantomotion 3 for providing the IDs. And don't forget that the downloading for Vive Tool and also the commands used in this video will will be in the article below in the video's description. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to leave a like below and also subscribe to the TechBase channel with the notification bell activated so that you won't miss any future uploads like this one. I was Emmanuel from TechBase. Until next time, have a nice day.